I think at this point, it's no secret that GM's LS and LT engines are really, really popular in the aftermarket world, as they're a great engine for swapping into your project car. They're really small and packaged very well thanks to their cam and block design. The OEM heads flow incredibly well. A simple cam swap can pick up as much as 100 horsepower and so much more. They really are the perfect engine for your project car. For the longest time, Gen 3, Gen 4, and Gen 5 small block V8 engines from GM have only been available in select sizes, which is 4.8 liters, 5.3 liters, 5.7 liters, 6 liters, 6.2 liters, and 7 liters. That is up until GM released their newest version of the LT, which is the L8T at 6.6 liters, which was designed as their new heavy-duty engine. So with that in mind, let's take a deep dive into the GM L8T and see what makes it so special as compared to every other LT engine. While the previous 6.2 liter L86 engine was pretty good, GM ultimately wanted to offer a gasoline engine with a lot more torque for truck customers who want to tow a lot but don't want to opt for the diesel 6.6 liter Duramax engine. And I know you might be wondering, who wouldn't want to opt for the diesel engine if they intend to tow? And while I agree with you, there are a handful of things that make a gas truck a more attractive option for very specific buyers, including the price of the truck when new, the price of 87 octane compared to diesel, availability of diesel fuel in their area, and so much more. So what they ended up doing is taking their Gen 5 small block, like the LT1, which was initially debuted in 2014 in the C7 Corvette, and basically changing it for heavy duty use. Now this includes a new block, a new displacement, a new intake, a new cam, and lack of some efficiency features, which have made the LT really, really fuel efficient. And all of that led up to an impressive power output of 401 horsepower and 464 pound-feet of torque on 87 octane. But at the end of the day, it is still a Gen 5 small block, which is incredibly similar to the Gen 3 and Gen 4 LS engines that everyone swaps into their project cars. So with that in mind, let's start from the bottom and work our way up on the L8T. The basis of the L8T is interesting for the simple fact that up until this point, every Gen 5 LT engine GM has produced uses an aluminum block with aluminum heads, but the L8T is completely different in the fact that it uses an iron block with aluminum heads. If you look back at Gen 3 and Gen 4 engines, iron blocks were used in the majority of truck engines, although not all of them, so it's certainly interesting to see them return to an iron block with the L8T. The most obvious reason for doing this would be the extra strength. But that being said, we've seen aluminum block LS engines reliably produce over 1,000 horsepower and 1,000 pound-feet of torque in the aftermarket world for literal decades now. So you could argue that the extra strength of an iron block isn't really needed, especially for a naturally aspirated truck engine. But ultimately, that's why they made the switch back. With that new burly iron block, they kept the bore the same as the L86, the LT4, the LT1, and so on, at 4.06 inches. But that being said, the cylinder liners were extended in length to help support the new 3.85 inch stroke, which is the biggest stroke on any OEM Gen 3, Gen 4, or Gen 5 small block engine, excluding the performance-oriented LSX engines. The block retains many of the Gen 3, Gen 4, and Gen 5 characteristics, with six fasteners with cross-bolted mains and a center-placed thrust bearing. Interestingly enough, it's been reported that the L8T block is only 12 pounds lighter than the Chevy Performance LSX blocks, which is definitely an indicator to how strong this block is and what it'll be able to take when aftermarket parts crank the power up. Another change that they made on the L8T is the lack of AFM or DFM, which is active fuel management or dynamic fuel management, and it's also void of start-stop. All of this means the hydraulic circuits for the lifters are not drilled, but the stands remain inside the lifter valley. The pistons have a 10.8 to 1 compression ratio, with bore and stroke measuring at 4.065 inches and 3.86 inches respectively. For anyone not familiar with the LT engine series, one of the biggest changes GM made going from the Gen 4 to the Gen 5 is the addition of direct injection, which is ultimately what allows the L8T to run on 87 octane while using a 10.8 to 1 compression ratio, which would be high for a Gen 3 or Gen 4 engine running on 87 octane, but it's no problem for the L8T thanks to the direct injection. Again, in the pursuit for strength, GM is using a forged steel crankshaft, which to be fair is pretty much standard across all LT engines. The crank does differ from the previous smaller iterations of the LT in the fact that it has an additional center counterweight to improve durability. The connecting rods retain the same 6.098 inch length of other LS engines, but unfortunately they are not interchangeable. because the L8T has a longer stroke with the stock 9.240 inch deck height. They use a smaller wrist pin diameter compared to the normal Gen 5 LT engine at 0.863 inch compared to the standard 0.927 inch. This was done to allow the standard length connecting rod while avoiding issues with the wrist pin intruding into the oil ring while still clearing the counterweight with the piston at bottom dead center. Another interesting change with the L8T is the variable oil pump, or a variable oil pressure pump, which basically means at low RPM, the oil pump is moving a lot less oil as compared to high RPM. So the oil pump basically just delivers the amount of oil that's needed for the given RPM and load, and this is to improve efficiency. Although when you really start to crank the power up and really get into the high RPMs, this can quickly become an issue. But for a stock truck, it's certainly no problem. But if you plan on building your L8T as a high RPM, maybe 1,000 horsepower engine, that variable oil pump is probably gonna have to go. As I mentioned earlier, the L8T is a direct injected engine. And because of that, the heads are very similar to any other Gen 5 cylinder head. All LT heads have the valve order different as compared to the earlier LS engines, which you can see here with the LS head on the right and the LT head on the left. The older heads place the exhaust valve at the front of the head, repeating in an exhaust intake pattern. The LT engines reverse this, placing the intake valve forward, repeating in an intake exhaust sequence. This, of course, also changes the lobe arrangement on the camshaft. Compared to other LT heads, the L8T heads offer an ever so slightly larger combustion chamber to help lower the compression ratio, since again, this engine was designed with 87 octane fuel in mind. And again, just like all other Gen 5 heads, the L8T heads feature surprisingly large intake ports with near line of sight to the intake valves. The valves on the L8T are also the same size as they are on the LT1, with a 2.126 inch intake valve. On the exhaust side of the head, it's again pretty much identical to any other Gen 5 head and offers raised exits for improved flow. Something that is worth noting on the L8T that's way different than any other LT engine is the fact that there are two alternators instead of one. And again, this is basically just for heavy duty applications. It's something that you really want on a heavy duty engine, so it's no surprise to see it here. On the aftermarket side of things, the L8T looks to probably be the most promising LT engine to date, thanks to the iron block and extended cylinder liners, which ultimately means if you were to bore and stroke this engine, you could see displacements of up to 7 liters or even more. And with the iron block, the block itself is gonna be able to hold up to massive amounts of power compared to the aluminum LT engine. So if you're boosting it, the L8T is going to be the strongest engine in the LT engine family. That is, unless you're going with an aftermarket race block. For reference, we haven't seen a 7-liter LS engine since the LS7. So the L8T having the ability to get that high up in displacement is really promising. And on the high end, we've already seen engine builders reach upwards of 2,000 horsepower with the L8T. So it's definitely going to be a favorite in the LT engine family, at least as far as engine building potential. And before we end this video, I do want to mention that on paper, the L8T barely appears to be any better than the existing 6.2 liter L86, with power outputs at 401 horsepower and 464 pound-feet of torque, and 420 horsepower and 460 pound-feet of torque, respectively. So on paper, the L8T is making 19 less horsepower and only 4 more pound-feet of torque, but that peak torque is delivered 100 RPM sooner. But that's just a paper measurement of peak power and torque. What really matters is the area under the curve, where the L8T's extra 400 cc's of displacement and longer intake runners will really show up. And compared to the old 6-liter truck engine, the L8T is a mile ahead. Although I would say it would have been cooler to see a new rendition of the Vortec 8100 as their alternative to the Duramax, but the L8T will have to do for now. So that's pretty much all I've got for you guys today. That is just a quick overview of what makes the L8T such an interesting engine. And in all reality, it is the best LT engine, at least as far as engine building potential, thanks to the extended cylinder liners and iron block that can hold up to massive amounts of power, which we've already seen with engine builders reaching upwards of 2,000 horsepower and just a little bit more. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to smash the thumbs up button, get subscribed so you don't miss out on future videos, check out some of the other stuff on the channel, and I will see you guys in the next one.